Yes, sir.
I'm gonna tell you all a little bit about my past.
Shut up!
Bitch!
I wasn't born into the royal family. I used to be the leader of a band of mercenaries that would go around and help kingdoms in their wars. In the beginning, things weren't easy. Nobody wanted to trust this poor band of dark elves. But we proved ourselves with our high intellect on the battlefield. We were of great help, and bit by bit, our band, called Doryoku, gained more and more popularity. As we went from kingdoms to kingdoms, we ended up working permanently for one of them, the Demon Kingdom. The king there was so happy with our work that he elevated us to Wild Gods. My band, now family, took a liking to it, and we all decided to live there. That's where I met the princess. We got to know each other and slowly became closer over the years. I ended up confessing my love to her, and she accepted me with the cutest smile on her face. I then decided to ask the king for his daughter's hand, and he surprisingly accepted on the spot, and thus I became a prince. Unfortunately, due to our incurable disease, the king passed away no long after. I was elevated as the king of the Shira Kingdom that became the Doryoku Kingdom when I took over.
Oi. Oi. Ningens. Welcome to the stream. What did you all think of my little lore video? This is the first time I do something like that. Using VRChat, I was like, why not? And I hope you all liked it. Thank you all for coming today. Thank you for the raids. I really appreciate it. So many of you all are here today. Okay, so I'm gonna have to present myself to the new people that came in here today. So let's do that, shall we? All the twerk is gonna be after the PowerPoint, okay? Okay, my name is Shonen Komarai, the ancient necromancer. I am 6'9". A lot of you Ningens are under 6 feet. I found that very interesting. I can step on some of y'all very easily. Will I do that though? I don't know, we will see. I am 2400 years old. Us dark elves live for a long time. That's why we end up having a lot of partners during our lives. I'm born the 2nd of February. It was not long ago, and it was great. We did a birthday party. with my friend Henry too. Like, that was her birthday too, and we had a great time. Too bad you all went there. You had to be there. You had to be there. I am an Aquarius. I personally do not care about it. I do not care about that, but some of y'all Ningians do, so if you all want to know, now you know. I live right at this moment in France. I live in France. Aha, baguette, ha ha, yes. I'm not even gonna lie to you. The jokes be funny. I am the king of the Doruka Kingdom, and I've been ruling for 5,000 years. It's been very eventful, and I cannot wait to get more human on my side. Now, the big question. A lot of you all been asking me, even those who've been following me for a while, what is a Ningen exactly? Ningen actually means human in Japanese, but I took the word's meaning and I changed it to all being. So if you are a dragon, you are Ningen. If you are a vampire, you are Ningen. If you are a frog, you are Ningen. If you are a succubus, you are Ningen. If you are a human, you are Ningen. Everybody is a Ningen. And if you think that this world is very close to another world that starts with N, you're right. Keep it pushing, my Ningen. Keep it pushing. Like, don't worry about it, alright? Don't worry about it. We know that you know that I know that you know. Don't worry about it. So now we're gonna go to my likes and dislikes. You know that I love virtual reality. It's even in my name. I fell in love with VR 3 years ago. It all started with me watching YouTubers playing VRChat. Some of you may know VRChat. It's a massively multiplayer game, a social game that people can play either on PC or in VR, right? So I've seen people playing this game. People like Drumzy, people like Malachichi, for those who know. And that inspired me to make more content, more VR content. That inspired me to make content around VR. Right. After that, I came across other YouTubers that actually don't play VR chats, but are centered around the VR industry. So they will talk about the softwares and the hardware, right? We will talk about all those headsets that I did not know. We talk about the Oculus Quest 2, now called the Meta Quest 2. Garbage ass name, trash, but that's beside the point. The Valve Index, the headset I have right now. The HP Reverb and many more. I got really invested in it. And I was like, one day, I'm gonna be a content creator with VR equipment. And here we are, 2 years later, with a VR headset, with y'all as a community. And this is just the beginning. I also really like French tacos. Basically, French tacos is like tortillas, right? And inside the tortillas, you put whatever meat you want. So if you want chicken, if you want beef, if you want like whatever type of meat you want, you put it in there. You have also a cheese sauce, right? Homemade cheese sauce, right? And French fries and spices. That's what is the French tacos. I have some images for you all. That shit is delicious. That is so fucking good. Oh my god. But yeah. That's so fucking good. Y'all have no idea. If you ever come to France, don't hesitate to try this out. Okay? If one of y'all, one of my mutuals come to France, I'm gonna make them eat that. Definitely. No question asked. Let's go back to the... Of course, I like anime and manga. My top three anime is Mob Psycho 100. I'm so sad that it's done, it's finished. There's no more Mob Psycho anymore. The anime was done like, I think last month or 2 months ago. I'm sad, but it was a very great story. Then my top two is Bakemonogatari. This one, it's more for the writing. And man, this shit can be sus as fuck on time, but the writing and the story is actually very good. I have a good memories of it. And then Marsh Comes in Like a Lion. That one is very, very emotional. Like, I really love the main character, Ray. Like, he's going through a lot. And you cannot, like, help yourself but to, like, be behind him and want him to do the best he can. Yeah, that's a really good one. I recommend this one, really. As for manga, my top one, Berserk. Man, when I read that the first time, that was the best binge I ever done in my life. That binge was so fucking good. Oh my god. Guts is one of my favorite main characters. Like, he inspired me. Like, this man has been through so fucking much. He's been through so fucking much, but he's keep going and going and going and going. He never gives up. Like, it's crazy how, like, strong his mental is. Guts can be up in them guts. Man, we always be all the ones like Black Butler. But yeah, I really like him. Second manga that I really, really like, my top two, Chainsaw Man. Man, the anime adaptation came up not long ago, but I've been reading the manga since it was out. And man, it's such a batshit crazy manga. Like, what the anime showed you all is nothing compared to what's gonna happen later. It's nothing. Like, you have no idea of the craziness that's gonna happen in Chainsaw Man. Makima, fuck this bitch, but she's a good villain. She's a good villain. A very good villain. She has a really good antagonist. But fuck her. She's a good antagonist to Denji. And then for the final one, my top three is One Punch Man. Like, the anime was very good for season one, but the manga is like eclipse the anime. Like, it's night and day. Murata is a demon. The man who draws One Punch Man is not human. He draws so fucking well. It's so good. Like, you're like, I ain't no fucking way. He's cracked. Genos can get it. Yo, all y'all are thinking about is fucking fictional characters, huh? That's all y'all thinking about, huh? Fucking fictional characters. You love that shit. Same.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. As for video games, One that I think you're all gonna be surprised about this one, but like one of my favorite is Mario Galaxy. I don't know if any of y'all played it before, but Mario Galaxy was very special to me. I don't know what it is with that game. I don't know what it was, but I fell in love with that. Yes, I have it. It's so good. Hey, I'm glad y'all are know about it. I'm so fucking glad. Ah, y'all real ones. Yes. Y'all real ones. But yeah. Like, so Mario Galaxy. There's another one that I really, really liked called Sonic Unleashed. I don't know if y'all play this, but Sonic Unleashed was a very good one. Like, it's in one of my favorites. I know a lot of people don't like it. But when I played this on the Wii, like, I had a lot of fun. It's my favorite game. Hey, yo, Henry. I love you. I fucking love you. I fucking love you. Yes. But then you have the Call of Duty series until Black Ops 2. That's for movies. I really, really liked the Infinity Saga from Marvel. So all the movies, not all, because some of those movies were trash, but like majority of the movies leading up to Endgame, that was something special. Captain America, Winter Soldier, Civil War, Infinity War, like those, chef kiss. But after that, I fell off after that. Then you have Ghibli movies like Howl's Moving Castle or Princess Mononoke that I really liked. Yeah, y'all funny. Y'all fucking funny. Alright. Then, man, I love my North African dishes, man. I love my North African food. I love my Senegalese food. I love my Malian food. I'm gonna show y'all two of my favorite dishes from where I come from. Because I was born in North Africa, Senegal, and grew up and came in France when I was 2 years old. Yeah, I'm breaking the immersion real quick, but I'm gonna tell you a lot right now. I'm only doing this this immersion thing a little bit. Like, I'm gonna not stay in character most of the time. Most of the time, you're gonna get me, Shonen, my personality, who I am, and a little bit of roleplay. So don't be surprised if I do not act like a dark elf king. Like, most of the time you're gonna get me. Alright. But yeah, like I was saying, those dishes, I'm gonna show you how they look like. You have the chebujen. Like, that shit's so fucking good. That shit's so fucking good, guys. Y'all have no ideas. That shit, I can eat that shit like every day. Every day. Every day. Every day. Then you have the mafé also. I'm eating that shit every day too. Every day. What I really like to do is making my friends laugh. Back when I was at school, like, I was a little bit of a clown, not gonna lie. Like, that's one of my favorite things to do. One thing I like to do also is beating.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is beating.
Yes, sir.
my friends up in games. Hi, Jax. I love beating your ass on Naruto. I love beating my friends in games. That shit feels so fucking good. I love it. I fucking love it. I fucking love it. I'm gonna looking at them like this. Gonna cry. Gonna cry, bitch. Yeah, get good. Get good.
Boom. I really like also to work out. I'm not going to the gym as much as I used to, but I make sure that I do my cardio. One thing that is very precious to me, very, very precious to me, is my alone time. Yes. I may look like an extrovert, but I'm definitely more ambivert than anything else. Like, I really, really like silence, be in my corner, having nobody check up on me, being on my own, and just doing my thing. I love that shit. I love that shit. But if I'm in the right environment, if I'm among friends, if I'm streaming, then my more outgoing side is gonna pop off. But yeah, I'm the two. I really like ass and thighs. Yes. Titties are nice. Titties are nice. Titties are great. But if I have to have a top three, it will go ass, thighs, and then titties. That's just me. That's just me. People who like barbecue sauce are not normal. That shit nasty. Barbecue sauce is nasty. That I don't know how you all put this shit on your meat. Pause. No. You whack, bro. That shit nasty as fuck. No, but more seriously. I have a hard time with barbecue sauce. Like, it's not the worst thing in the world. Like, it's not, clearly not. But man, I have a hard time. I always have been, like, struggling with that shit. Okay. My meat go crazy with sweet baby rays and you're gonna respect it. Now clipping that. Damn, are you getting cancelled? Hey, I made it. I fucking made it. I'm already cancelled. Yeah, let's fucking go. Let's fucking go. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. But yeah, that's not for me. That's not for me. It's clearly not for me. Then. Ooh, this one. Fucking liars. Ooh. Especially the liars that I know they are, and I have evidence that they lied to me, but they still lie to my face. I know who you are. I know who you are. I know how you are. Keep going. Keep going. Make yourself look like a fool. Because I know. And I'm gonna make sure you stay far away from me and my people. Yeah, like Henry said, it's even funnier when they snitch on themselves. Oh, this is chef kiss. That's the best feeling. When they snitch on themselves because they've been lying so much. You're like, ah, I got you, bitch. There you go. Now, that's another thing that I really don't like. Crowded places. Oh my god. Yo, anytime I'm in a crowded places, all I think about is like, yo, can I get home? I just want to get to be home, read my manga, watch my YouTube videos, like clap some ass, you know? Like giving all that tongue action, you know? All that shit. But no. I have to stay between all those people, and some people stink! Some people stink. They stink, man. You hear like, man, I'm really stuck. I'm really stuck. You can't escape. Like, the breath, horrendous. Breath, horrendous. Armpit, no. Bro, I'll be like, yo, let me get home. Please, please let me get home. I beg you. Nah, cuz nah, when it's crowded, you are forced to deal with people who have no fucking ear hygiene. Like, hygiene is very important to me. So, like, that's why I cannot handle crowded places. Whew, I'm having PTSD right now. I'm having PTSD. I'm thinking about, oh my god. I remember this one time, you had this guy, he smelled like poop. And I was stuck near him for 1 fucking hour. For 1 fucking hour. Do you realize? 1 fucking hour of this shit. Oh my god. Oh my god. Never again. Never again. Anyway. Another place that I don't like, the hospital. This one is not because of the smell, but more because, like, I don't know. When I go to the hospital, it takes my whole day, even though I don't have anything crazy. And I'm so fucking grateful. I'm so fucking grateful that I'm a dark elf. So I rarely, rarely, I'm rarely sick. But when I do, and I have to go to the hospital, ooh, like, I hate it. I fucking hate it. I just want to get home. I just want to be home. Losing to my friends in video games. Like, because I know they're gonna brag, they're gonna be so petty about it, because I am petty about it when I win. So I know it's coming. I know it's coming. So I'm always like, damn. Damn, we're gonna be on my ass. We're gonna be on my ass. One thing I really don't like too is puzzle games. Thank you for the Shonen Redemption. Puzzle games. I have actually a love-hate relationship with them.
Yes, sir.
I have a love-hate relationship with them. I love the feeling of, like, finding the solution to a puzzle. I love it when I can say, like, yeah, figure it out all by myself. I feel smart as fuck. But the journey to that is so fucking painful. It ain't worth it. I don't think there's one person that like time zone difference. Yo, man. It's so... I'm fighting for my fucking life to hang out with my homies. I'm fighting for my life. I'm fighting for my life, man. It's hard. It's hard out here. It's hard. It's hard. Especially when majority of my friends come from the US. Majority of them are from the US. My online friends, they are all over there. They're almost all Americans. But hey, it is what it is. That's my chair.
Over here, that fuck ass lawn chair. Over here sitting on that Uncle Chair at the cookout. That chair is on its last leg, my boy. Its last leg. Go put the chair back in the living room where you found it. Mom wants a stepping stool back. Hey, you better stop. Them legs gonna give out on you.
Having one monitor. I hate that shit. That shit's so fucking annoying. That shit's so fucking annoying. I'm not ending 2023 without having a second monitor, especially as a streamer. Mm-mm. This is not happening. I'm getting one. I'm fucking getting one. So my goals. I'm trying to build a great community and to my family that I can be a successful content creator. Because most of them, they don't believe in me like that. They are like, yo, this is not gonna work. It's not gonna work. You need to stop it. And I told them, just watch. Just watch me. I want to be an inspiration for my fellow black content creators. I have a propaganda to spread. And that propaganda is virtual reality. I'm gonna make sure that as much people as I know get into VR. Because y'all are do not realize how fun and how great VR is. I'm gonna make it my mission. I'm gonna make it my mission to make y'all like this shit. And it's gonna spread like wildfire. This is just the beginning. And finally, to stay true to myself. And to not get an ego, starting to treat other people in a trashy way. That's why I surrounded myself with people that would actually check me out and make sure that I stay humble. Because I do not need a bunch of yes men around me. So, for the fun. Y'all don't have a... Everybody that follow me and join the kingdom will get a free headset. As for my people, what are they called? Ningens. As for my streams, I mostly stream VR games, but I also happen to play games on flat screen, like Fall Guys, like Valorant, like Overwatch, like Fortnite, all those kind of games. I play those too, but I mainly play VR games on stream. My favorite genre are horror games, FPS, adventure, and social. Basically, social is just VR chat. I really like that game. I usually stream between 3 and 6 p.m. EST. The person who did my design is CJ. CJ, CJ, CJ. CJ is so fucking talented. And the one who did the 3D model is Big Ningen Zealous. We have our special thanks again to CJ and Zealous, because without them we wouldn't be here. My staff, my community, and Brandon Fitcher for the BGM. I asked him if I could use the BGM, and he allowed me to, so a big thanks to you. Bitch, focus. Oi! Focus, bitch! Hey! Bro, focus! Fuck was that? I have a cape. Hold on.
Whee! Wow! 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 Wow!
Yeah. Okay. my back. Okay. You have the Doryoku written in my back. Doryoku in Japanese. And the crown right above. I think it looks pretty cool. What do you all think? I really like it. I'm gonna show you all my underwear. Twitch, chill. I'm not gonna pull my cock out, okay? I'm not putting my cock out. I'm gonna show something very funny, alright? Alright. Hey, yo, Chanel! Bro. There you go. Big Poopy Shonen, yeah. Yeah. Yo, I'm caked up. As you can see, I am caked up. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Ah, let me put my things up. There you go.
Shake my money maker. It's time for the circulator. 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 Jay-Z, I'm fly with it. Slim thick pussy with it. She wet with the key missing. One time for my freak. After hour, no sleep. When I get my freak on, they throwing money like me chong. When I do my dance, money fight, these throwing pins. JC, I ain't playing. Lil' boo, I don't want your men. But these rich throwing paper. Now it's time for the circulator.
That's a quick on turkey popping like a Cuban Texas. Ow. I'm a city girl, y'all. It's some hooch. Don't stop, pop that pop on some loop. All of that cute, break it down for that loop. Percolate that paper straight. I'ma percolate at the after hours. We percolate.
What's this? No, fuck!